So I didn't really film any of this, but here's an update for you. New lines all the way through the damn C20. I still gotta mount that. I know it's wibbly-dibbly-dee, but you know, there's a mount supposed to go where that bolt's sticking out up there. I just left it in there so I know where it's supposed to go. I'm gonna put that mount in and one more up there. These lines are from LMC truck, which came from inline tube. This is just a local parts store. I made these. They're not pretty and factory bent, but they are held on. One spot there and two over here. One there and one there. So, yeah. Despite that, and despite bleeding the hell out of these brakes, I can't get a good pedal feel out of this truck, and I don't know why. I'm at an impasse. I don't know why. I also don't like the way that's right up against there. There we go. That's better. It was right up against that damn U-bolt. I don't like that. That'll be rubbity-dub-dub-dub. That ain't leaking, is it? Surely not. It's probably just left over from where I was bleeding them. Yeah, nah, that ain't leaking. In other news, gas tank's still leaking. That one's still not hooked up. I might just take a gander down in that one and see how it looks, and then just hook the lines up to it rather than it and use that one, because I'd rather have one over here than over there. But I gotta see what kind of mess that tank looks like, and it might just leak any damn way. Just took it down the road. It seemed to do good. Still getting used to the old sloppy 465. I wonder what they had welded under here. Another trailer hitch? Maybe? So this is just a bolt down job. But maybe they did. Some in there. And there. This truck never had a fifth wheel in it that I could tell. There ain't no holes drilled through the bed, so that's good. At least it didn't get towed to death with a fifth wheel. Might have with someone else, though. Ooh. That's interesting. Just sandwich it in there. These springs. You can tell it's a 3/4 ton. Yeah, basically all the lines except for the, two at the, coming down from the master cylinder to the proportion valver. Those two aren't new, but everything else is. Oh yeah, and look what I found. My parking lights aren't working either. What even is all this shit? And what does that go to? Nothing. What does that go to? Nothing. Nothing. One of these is probably my damn parking lights. Oh, fuck. Oh, God, why? Oh, yeah. I wonder what this is. Someone with the trailer wiring. It's unhooked. Where was it? Yeah. Bare wire there for the, license plate light going over there. Still bare. I didn't do any of this. I think, which one of these is the body harness? I don't know. Yeah. Unfortunately, it's the body harness side that's been butchered, not the other side. So, there's really nothing I can do but pull all this shit out that I can. Because I think it had a factory plug on it, and they just butchered some other shit on here. Like this. Yep. Hey. Highly doubt that works. Hang on. I'm crawling out. Oh, God. So I started the video down here. Believe it or not, the license plate light does work. I will replace that so it doesn't blow the bulb. But, yeah, my parking lights aren't working at all. I got to check that. Nasty fucking brake fluid towel. And windshield still cracked. Nothing changed really in here. Except it's a bit of a mess. Windows still suck. Put up, driver's side especially. Ooh. Also, looky what I got. Some chrome vent shades. Like them or love them? I love them. And spare taillight lenses. Got a couple door latches somewhere in here. Because that door latch over there is bad. Very bad. It's weird. This was an upper trim truck, but it only came with a center channel radio. Well, it was a custom deluxe, but still, you know, air conditioning. Weird truck. 354 barrel air conditioning, 3/4 ton. Some new lug nuts on this side and the other, because they wouldn't go back on. They were too good for their homes. Nothing's really changed on the engine except I got the steering pump on, belts, steering box leaks. So, with a brake master cylinder, I got one from Advance. There's a reman because I couldn't find a new one. Turns out Napa actually might possibly have a new one. I haven't called them to verify, but their website says they do. But, you know, I can't really trust the website. Anyway, the reman that I had on here blew, and I hadn't even put a mile on it. I mean, I literally just put on here blood to brakes, and you could see what it did. And, yeah, so I got another one. Swapped that out. We'll see if this one holds up. But I can't get a damn pedal feel out of this thing. I'm about ready to just take it back and be like, look, y'all got to do something because I can't get no damn pedal feel out of it. More new lug nuts over here. It's got new calipers, hoses. You can see the new hoses down there. New lines. New that. Well. Oh, it's on this side, dummy. There's the new caliper. Both sides, new pads. I hadn't really touched the drums, but they seem to be working. They're not leaking. Valve cover gaskets are done. New PCV grommet and hose. I did away with the factory oil breather over here and just put in a breather. Starter was done by the previous owner. I think it was done in 2020, according to some paperwork I found. Yeah. Better them than me. I put the battery in here, and yeah, that's really it. Oh, these headlights. I put those in. Love them or hate them, they were cheap. I got a new adjuster I got to put in on this side. That one kind of disintegrated the moment I tried to adjust it. And my bow tie fell off and broke. I was working on the truck one day, and they just fell off and broke. Anyway, that's all on the old Chevrolet C20 here. She's been fighting me tooth and damn nail. Don't want to. She wants to live. She just don't want to stop. I think she wants to live on the wild side a bit. I'm on the fence with this headache rack. I like it, but it's too damn tall. I'd like to find one that's meant for one of these trucks. That's off of a later truck, I think, like a 90s Chevy. But yeah, where's the damn? What do I do with my damn keys? Sorry, a bit tired, so enthusiasm has left the building. Come on, the hateful thing. It's warm, mind you, but even with that junky wore-out quadrajet, it fires right up. Temperature gauge is unhooked, because if I hook it up, well, for one, the wire's broke, but if I hook it up, the temperature goes up about a quarter, then all the way over to full, even though it's not even hot. Voltage gauge seems to work? Question mark? Oil pressure gauge works. Nothing here. That would have been a clock on the higher trim trucks. See, it's weird. It's an air conditioning truck, but it's got like no options. Well, it was an air conditioning truck before they ripped it all out of here. And factory cassette. That was not a cheap option. Not 1983. Assuming it was factory cassette, I don't know for sure. But yeah. All my tools and shit scattered through here. I spilled my damn metric tool can over there, and there's metric tools all over the inside of my truck. Anything up here? Handprints. Nope. So, yep. Fix the dome light. I gotta take the steering wheel off and figure out why the horn ain't working, figure out why my hazards ain't working, because they gotta work for Virginia inspection. Left signal, right signal. I was told my parking lights ain't working. Let's see, shall we? Oh, this has got this funky little thing. If you ever run into this where your key won't turn off in your old Chevy trucks, press this little thing down, turn the key, turns off. I don't know why. That's just what they did. But yeah, that little stick sticking out there is supposed to be my hazard switch. And, it don't do nothing. It's supposed to pull out to turn on and... Nah, it's dead. Oh, shit, I meant to leave the key on. Get carried away. Where's the fucking key now? Okay. Key's on. Man, shut up. Damn it. There it goes. Into reverse and pretty much in the seat. You're not going to have a center passenger here unless they like a gear stick between their legs. Well, I'll have to investigate that. But yeah, all the other lights are working, so I don't really care. Oh boy. I really don't want to have to dig into that can of worms. If it turns out I can't get power back there, and then reverse switch is working on the transmission, I guess I'll just run... I don't know if the reverse switch is ground-based. I'm assuming it's a ground-based switch. And if it is, I'll just install a relay and put some, like, an LED fucking light on my bumper. Just drill a hole, like, right here and just put an LED light on there, and that'll work for parking light. That's all Virginia cares about. But yeah. Well, the tailgate was working. I don't know what happened there. It has chosen to no longer operate. That's one of the reasons why I bought this tailgate. This truck is because the tailgate just worked like butter. Ooh, a socket. What are you? One of my metric ones? Yep. Good thing it ain't got holes in the floor. Like my last one. This thing ain't even really bolted on. Quadra junk. Okay, so yeah. Ramble-O-Tron is coming to an end. Everything seems fine. That's not a new fuel pump. I pressure washed the engine before I did any work to it because it was disgusting. I mean, do you see the black there in the front of the head and down the front of the intake? Yeah, it was like that, but 10 times worse. And if you're wondering what this funny hose is that I got here, I'm not sure if that's going to hold up, but it's leftover power steering hose where I got the return hose. Because you can just replace the return hose here. You just break the little permanent snips. You don't want to use that in the pressure hose. It'll blow off. But the return hose, you can. And if you don't know which, you probably shouldn't be messing with it. And that crumbly mess right there on the mount is the old grommet. I had to replace both of those because they was just... There's no point in doing your valve cover gaskets if you don't replace these grommets because it's going to come out of them next. The oil's going to find its way out. You can plug one leak, but it's going to find its way out. But the valve covers are usually the worst offender. Other than that, I noticed it needs rear shocks. And I think that will be the end of this video. I'm going to show this one is under there. But yeah. Just kind of wiggly, 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 wiggle. That's not right. Something wrong, but they're not too hard to do. I could shoot a cordless impact through there and a bajillion sockets and get it done. I guess I'm gonna have to check the drums and see why I'm not getting any brakes. I don't really want to do that. And when I get tires from this sucker, I'm getting them rotated because you look, see, those are deeper. Anyway, oh. I don't remember the badges being that crooked from the factory, were they? Against the body lines like that? Maybe they were. Oh, I need the side marker for the other side, too. Yeah. Side marker, horn, fix the parking brake, some kind of reverse light, make the brakes about 5 to 10% better, and it should pass inspection. Oh, and that wiper, because, he's no bueno, amigo. It's, yeah. It's fine. It'll be fine. Yeah, no. It's cheap fucking garbage. I think it needs a wiper motor, too, because they just kind of, I leave the M key on. I did. Yeah, I don't know why that would be like that, but that's another thing I got to get after with the multimeter. Figure out where my voltages are going and if it's a voltage issue or what, but that's just sad. And if you're screaming at me for running wipers on a dry windshield, please look at item number A, B, and 3. Okay, so don't. I guess I will leave it with, huzzah, the highest of high beams, because these things are silly. Ugh. Shut up, you stupid bird. Yeah, these things are very bright, comrade. Well, it's actually, there you go. Anyway, that'll do it for now. Are all my lights really working? Do I believe it? Well, I guess I do. Are they bright? No. Do I care? No. Hi in there. How's it going? It'll pass. Barely. But it'll pass. What I want to do is get whole new fixtures back here and put the old lenses on, because I don't like... Ooh! Side marker came back on. Cool. What if it'll work over here, too? Aha! It's alive! Sweet. Cool. Oh, that sounded crunchy. Let's not do that anymore. Yeah, let's not do that anymore. But, hey, side marker started working again. Cool. Alright. That's it for now on the C20. I guess. Do a little bit more piddling shit. The adjuster, the horn, some kind of parking light, parking brake, and a wiper, and try to make them go faster. Maybe. And it should pass. Oh, the door hinges. Yeah, I really need to fix the door hinges. Because, I mean, it does shut, but not very well. Yeah. Do that, and it should be good to go for Virginia State inspection. No catalytic converter or nothing like that, because it's a C20 and federal emissions is all that Virginia went by. Anyway, that's the end of this Ramble-O-Tron. Thanks for watching.